morning students, today we are going to discuss about the lesson Social Transformation in Tamil Nadu. The topic is about Periyar. As a president of a Tamil Nadu Congress, Periyar proposed a resolution. What is the resolution? The rights of untouchables to temple entry. The name of the caste Dharma, the lower caste people were denied access to the temples and the streets surrounding temples. In Vaikom, in a town in the princely state of Trivangur and the present day of Kerala, the people protested against this practice. The initial stage, the George Joseph of Madurai played a big role. After the local leaders were arrested, and then Periyar led the movement and was imprisoned. The people hailed him as Vaikom Veerar or Hero of Vaikom. At the same time, Periyar was disturbed by the Cheranma Devi Kurukulam school. What are the disturbances? The disturbance was the caste-based discrimination in the dining hall in the school, which was run by V. Subramaniam. He was a Congress leader. He was supported by the Tamil Nadu Congress Committee, financial support by the Tamil Nadu Congress Committee. So the Periyar was disappointed when, despite his objection and protest against his discrimination, the Congress continued the practice in the curriculum. So he left the Congress Committee and he started the self-respect movement in 1925. Periyar spread the news or thoughts or ideas. He started a number of newspapers and journals. What are they? First one, Kudiyarasu or Democracy in 1925, Revolt 1928, Purachi or Revolution 1933, Pahuttarivu or Rationalism 1934, and Vidudalai Liberation 1935. The Kudiyarasu was the official newspaper of the self-respect movement. It brought the multiple voice and ideas of non-Brahmin women and religious minorities. Usually, Periyar wrote a column and expressed his opinion on social issues on each of its issues. He frequently wrote column under the pseudonym of Chitraputran. Periyar had a close relationship with Singaravelar. He was the first communist of South India and then he was a pioneer of Buddhism. In 1936, Periyar got Dr. B.R. Ambedkar's Annihilation of Caste translated into Tamil immediately after it was written. He also supported Ambedkar's demand for separate electorate for scheduled caste. In 1937, the opposition of Rajaji government. Why the opposition of Rajaji government? The anti-Hindi agitation. Because of the anti-Hindi agitation in 1937 and 39, it had a big impact of Tamil Nadu politics. So Periyar was imprisoned for his role in the movement. When he was still in jail, Periyar was elected as the president of Justice Party. So the Justice Party merged with the self-respect movement. It was Recrescent and the Dravidar Kalaham in 1944. Rajaji, the Chief Minister of Madras Presidency, Madras State in 1952-1954, he introduced the vocational education program. It was the imparting school children with training in a tune with their father's occupation. It is called the Kulakalvi Thittam. So the Periyar criticized the Kulakalvi Thittam. It was in the caste-based education scheme. His campaigns against it lead to the resignation of the Rajaji. Next, Kamaraj became the chief minister of the Madras state. Periyar died at the age of 94 in 1973. His mortal remains were buried at Periyar Thidal, Madras. Next topic is Periyar, a feminist. Periyar condemned the child marriage and Devadasi system. Right from 1929, the self-respect conference began. It voiced concern over the plight of women. Periyar had been emphasizing human right to divorce and property. Periyar rejected the terms like giving in marriage because he said the treats of women as a thing. he wants to substituted by வாழ்க்கை துணை or companion, a word for marriage taken from the Tirukural. பெரியார் most important work as the subject is why the women since enslaved. பெரியார் believed that property is the right for women, so the property would provide them in the social status and protections for women. In 1989, the government of Tamil Nadu fulfilled the dream of the racial reformers and in introduction of the Hindu Succession Amendment Act of 1989. And then which ensured the equal rights to ancestral property for women in inheritance. Next, let us see about the Rettai Malai Srinivasan. The Rettai Malai Srinivasan period is 1859 to 1945. He was known as Grandpa or Tata. He was born in Kanchipuram in 1859. He was fought for social justice, equality and civil rights of the marginalized people. His selfless social service, he honored some such titles, Rao Saheb 1926, Rao Bahadur 1930 and Diwan Bahadur 1936. His autobiography is G.V.S. Haritha Surukam. A brief autobiography. It was published in 1939. It is one of the earliest autobiographies. Rettai Malai Srinivasan worked for the progress and deprived caste. He founded Adi Dravida Mahajana Sabha in 1893 and also he served as the president of the Scheduled Caste, the Federation and the Madras Provincial Depressed Class Federation. He was close associated with Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, so he participated in the first and second roundtable conference in London 1930 and 31. He was opinion of the marginalized section of society and then he was a signatory to the Pune Pact of 1932.